Zeller, Gunesh. Turkish attention. This is how that was how they were lining up. You saw that graphic. Dizem is the starting lead below. It's a good team for Vakif Bank. It's a good team for Detti has. He knows that there's no pressure on his team. They are the underdogs. He said that already prior to this one starting. He said that his team is just going to play free, not carefree, but free, no pressure. Try to enjoy themselves as much as possible. And actually, when you're playing like that, that's when upsets can happen. Best of five sets. So he will be playing for gold. Fighting to make it to the podium. Players are on court, they're ready, the crowd are in, they're ready. And we are so close to getting this first semi-final underway here in Shaoxing. Vakif Bank Istanbul in the black and yellow from Turkey have the serve. It's Yumoko Voli. Conegliano in the white and blue receiving. First point goes the way of the Italian side, Conegliano. This is the first semi-final from the FIVB Women's World Club Championship here in Shaoxing, China. Clough to serve. Work by Gisem. Pick up from Hill, looking to come on that pipe. Silja has to go with the tip. That's a good pick up from Hark. This rally continuing on. No one's out of real full swing. Silja does, but it's continuation. She's now out of the play. Hill's involved. Up from Gabby. Oh, yes. Sofia Milic with a little bit of magic to get that very long rally finished. Because none of the hitters could get the job done. So Ognjenović, 35 years of age, he's been there, done that, won it, got the t-shirt, and then some. Comes up with a little bit of skill to get the point. Trouble here for Conegliano, free ball. Hark, big swing, but not found the sideline. It's going to be an interesting battle across the various positions for these two teams. Ngannou against Hark, Silja against Gabby, Karakunz against Hill, and Volosh, I should say. The L's got a little line across it, which turns it into a W in Polish. The W's pronounced as a D. Volosh against Ognjenović. Setters. When you look at that, when you look at the matchup. Player for player, there's not much in it. It's going to come down, you feel, to the cohesion of the team, the way that they can play together, and also how they can deal with this current situation. Semi-final of a World Club Championship. With a very confident player, still learning the trade, still a little bit raw in places, technically, still a few minor things to be working on. Certainly good enough to be starting, and certainly, and in fact, starting ahead of Mihailo Ismailoglu. He's been starting. Ismailoglu with 114 odd caps for the national team. He's been hosted by the youngster Kanker for this one. So Kanker's like 54, she's only 19. Silja looking to do the same thing from Conegliano here. Sorry, I couldn't handle that one. Team still testing each other out at the moment, dancing around the ring. Their range. It's a good serve from Foley. This is a tricky one, too tricky in the end for Gabby. The ball's gone way too wide. So a few errors just creeping into Becky Frank's play. We're really not having to really work for some of the points at the moment. Foley will serve once again. Played. A positive set from Rogmianovic, in so much as that she used that ball from Gabby, continued it on its way behind her head for Hack to have the swing. So it's a quick play. So much so that the court was never going to get out and help, but going over the top of the hill with the swing from her. Now Milena Rasic, former Serbian international, in the middle with the serve. And well past that from Gizem Ognjenovic. A cheeky little shoot to the middle. Ognjenovic keeps it in play. Oh, good dig. Well, it's just front court, she can play it. And now a better chance here for Conegliano. Siliav, just the roll shot, so now advantage back to that Keith Bank. That looked a little bit sticky in the hand of Hack. But she gets away with it. After all, volleyball, not catch and throw ball. It's the setters who get that kind of license to play the ball in that manner. It might as well have been the angle which Tanja Kamen was presenting us with that shot. Inside 10, but good defending again from Bakif Bek. The 50 gets run. That's good improvisation. Silia. Good up from De Janeiro. Igonu. Oh, well played by Igonu. Back row. Not even a runner. Pretty much just jumped from the three. And still got a swing on the ball. Yeah, lead by three. First technical. So far, so good for Conegliano. Hill to serve. Good dig from the lines person. Good swing from Hako, but it hit the lines person. Shrugs it off. Goodness, that was a big mishit from Hack. That wasn't. That's really well played from Ognjenovic, because Hack's just made a howler. And she goes right back to her and says, come on, get yourself back in it. And she does. With this shot. It's incredible. Gavin's serve. Karakut into the front row. Deciding not to have a swing on there. Gabby forces that one. So a little bit of the net getting through the block. So Foley showing no emotion for the moment. Good touch from Celia. not with a touch from DeCroft. Hits. Good dig by Gabby. Good up from Sinia. Well, that's come off the block. So it's a good play in the end from Conegliano Gonu. Flipping the fingers of Akif Beck's block as that ball went out. It was Di Zera trying to make the block, but unsuccessfully so. From this angle from Mebra Kanakert. She's got to face at position five. It's not an easy day at the office for either Libero from the two teams. And all the firepower is on display. Gonu again, flipping fingers. She hits the ball so high. But she doesn't hit it steep. She does go towards the baseline. So that ball's got to come from height. And it is travelling 8 metres. So the opportunities may well be to say, do you know what? Let's not try and reach up and touch that ball. Let's get across, close angles if he tries to go steep, but see if our defence can play a bit more of that ball deeper in our defensive play. Good up for Gabby. Is that one slowed down by the block? Good up by De Janeiro. Yes, good cover from Ognjenović. Hack with work to do. Ball gets twisted. De Janeiro. With a good recovery. Free ball for Vakif Bank. Two front court, two back court. And it's the third front court in Ognjenović, who goes over on two. That's twice she's done that now. She's getting the better of Conegliano's block. This is such a good play because Cilia wasn't ready for it. But Gennaro does the right thing, keeps it in play. This is great stuff from Vakif Bank. Just one behind at the moment in this first set of this first semi-final. That's where you have to put somebody in the cross court with a hard hat on. Really try and dig that play. Split Gabby and Kisset. Brilliant. Sinia. Well left by Gizem. Karakurt's got a big jump serve on her. Heck, showing like she's going to be blocking line, I would suggest. Take Hill on the line. That didn't happen. What a swing that was. Desi's like, what? Oh, I thought you were blocking line. He's not happy, is he? And that's because, and the reason he's unhappy is because Heck was supposed to be blocking the line. How much did she leave? Not too much. That's a great swing, though, nonetheless, from Hill. Good going from Gabby. So important, the movement around the centre from the hitters, the attackers, being available, coming in and pinning the blockers on the other side of the net. Because when you do that, as has happened here, the Cruyff is then late to get out. Such, her hands are away from the net, and the ball goes from her hands into the net and down, as opposed to going down on the side of Becky. It's Gonu. Definitely got to close those angles so she can't hit that steep ball. Got to make her go over the top of the blocks, as Becky Bank were doing earlier. Incredibly, Gonu is jump serving from behind the baseline. Still yet to get that technique right to get the consistency in the throw so that she's travelling into court. Watch Isabella Hack really good. She's contacting that about a metre into court, so the ball's coming from 8 metres away as opposed to 9, 10, 11 even for Ganu. So that ball's coming faster, you've got less time. International, they were 32nd in the European Championships. Oh, really good pickup by De Janeiro. And finish from Ngannou. We just saw a spike from Hack, not a serve. That wasn't passing, that was defending. But, that defence then turned into transition under the umbrella of side out. De Janeiro. Those are important digs, if they, especially if they can be converted, which they are. That's a big break point, which takes Conegliano to the technical timeout, leading by two in this first set. Trouble for Van Kiefbank. Good pickup, Gizem. Gabby trying to get the block out, wasn't going to go wide enough. Hark comes up with the play. So the side out achieved, and that is all it is. Kind of spin you put on it. Kiefbank will look at that as a big point. It's not really, it's a struggle. A couple of goes at it. Leon have been siding out. It's easily like that from Silla. Silla touches 320 in spike, along with Kimberly Hill. Nine players in this squad, over 3 metres in terms of their spiking. To the last third of this first set now. We've had the race to 8, we've had the race to 16, the race to 25. To Vakifbank's credit, they were 3 behind in the first technical, 2 behind in the second. Been closing the gap. But this is where you traditionally see the team that has the better team pull away in the last third. Pressure begins to mount on the other team. We'll see how that goes. Oh, my goodness me! Spike Tang doesn't do that justice. Quartet is the same as like, what just happened then? That's mental. That is an unbelievably good swing from Garica. Good leave. That's a shame. I think you get such a good play like that from Ebra, and then Tino goes back and serves the ball out. Good out from Silla. Big swing from Ngonu. I think she caught the hands. She's going to be saying that there's a touch, so they'll challenge that. Just press the button for challenge. So what you've got to do. Don't need to go crazy. This is the thing now. You've got the challenge system, so it's all that. All of that going mental as a coach. Oh, touch. Oh, Jimmy, it's a big touch. Great. There was a big touch. It was hit so fast, no one spotted it. He just pressed the button. Well done, Mr. Eskipalski. He's given the touch without having to go that far. That's what the challenge system is for. No need to go for it for that one. That was pretty standard stuff from Ngonu. Big gap in the block. Interesting battle is between, in fact, Hebra and Ngonu. Oh, so it's over the top of Gavin. And Hebra not making the dig. Substitution for Cornegliano as in comes Eleonora Fassino. Coming in for Vakif Bank is Maria Isimeoglu. Has been starting in matches as an outside hitter. In for Karakurt to show up the defence, make the pass work a bit better. They need to win this set. So far so good for Conegliano. They side out, they go two in front. That's a great ball from De Janeiro, which enables to craft out a swing through the middle. Substitution change, so Gusto off. Message on to go off for the Libra to come in. Going over the serve. Serve routine, just do what you normally do, don't let the situation get the better of you. Hack more than capable of turning things around in this set with their serving, just like that. No middle coming, slightly quicker ball out wide, and that's off the block and away from Hill. Oh no, it might not be actually looking at that. There it is, just look for a minute as if she didn't get the touch. Serve from Hill. Never really developed a jump serve. Gabby, brilliant. She's jumped in a little bit early, potentially, but really created some wonderful space by moving her shoulders back to be able to hit that line. They've run out back into the front row. Ismailoglu's job has been done across the back for the passing and defending, and now Ebra will try and make something happen at the net. Gabby with the serve. Keith Bank still need 2 points from serve to go in front. They might get one here. Oh, they won't though, because it's not caught the block. Oh, no, it hasn't. Oh dear, what a shame. Challenge has been requested. And De Kruijf said, no, I didn't touch it. That was just because Santarelli was asking. He said, no. You're not in trouble if you did touch it. Although Vakif Bank may well be in trouble if there is no touch here, because 23, Conegliano serving, they're in a really good position. No touch. Fortunately, De Kruijf had cut her fingernails before the start of this one. Fully into the front row, De Kruijf to serve. Big front row as well with Celia Foley on. Borosch may be the target, especially Scott Hebra to deal with. Time record by Vakif Bank.
we are doing amazing. We are touching, we are reading, everything in the middle. Only remember keeping the linear.
Well, that's really good to see from Guidetti. He has been at times during the course of this tournament really upset with his players and spending a time out just telling them what they've done wrong. But complete contrast, telling them how well they're playing, they're making great touches, they're in this match, and just keeping that confidence high and that instilling that belief in his players, and that's really, really important. It is a good test as well for that Keith Bank, and that's what Guidetti wants. He wants his players tested. He wants to know how good they are. He wants to know how they can improve and what they need to do to improve. That's a great pass from Serra. And a wonderful put away from Hack. Side out achieved. Is there going to be a turning point in this set for that Keith Bank, or are Conegliano just going to keep motoring along like a side out machine? Been. That's a top ball in, but really good touch in the block from Rasic. Hack. Oh, she's done it. She gets it through the block. But Keith Bank have got back level. That's quite a big point. Santorelli knows it. He's called a timeout. But Keith Bank are level. Kansu is in. And the backup setter to serve. She's got a good serve on her, actually. Good dig, Gabby. Oh, wow. A little bit of luck, maybe, for Foley. She didn't get the contact she wanted. Kansu stuck herself in there and said, I can make the dig. And it's Conegliano who get the side out. But they have set point, but you get the feeling this is going to go to 24-all. And if it does, Keith Bank have felt really, really good about that. Bank calling the timeout. Is good for that Keith Bank. Smiles, shoulders up, heads up. The confidence in what they're doing. Emiliano, the verge of the set, but it's not guaranteed. Fans who've made the travel from Europe to China, rewarded with a little time on the big screen. Oh, Hack's gone for that, but not made the touch. And that will be the first set to Conegliano. I think we'll have a challenge, though, just to be sure. But look at the reaction from Hack. She knows it. Guidetti knows it. He's going to have a challenge, but he's got his back on. He's ready to go to the other side. And it's just come down. Just that one unforced error, really, at such a critical moment that has cost Keith Bank the set. But a really good first set. Keith Bank will... Goodness, when you see it from that angle, yeah, it's not even close, is it? Goodness me. When you're watching it, I was looking at the screen at the time and seeing it from that angle. So Guidetti calls the challenge, but he knows it's over. But he's still happy with his team's performance, and why not? That was really good, and they had chances. Can they do the same again? They've got to believe as we get ready for the second set. Conegliano taking the first, 25-23. So the one error, there was that one at the key moment, but 10 overall from the Keith Bank according to the statistics, and Conegliano just the 5. So you think about that, if that Keith Bank had only made 5, they would have won. They would have won that set, probably won it. Quite well, we say that. Yeah, maybe that they didn't get it. They only made 5 unforced errors, but then Conegliano got an extra 5 points in attack and made a block. Doug, ifs, whats, maybes, shoulda, woulda, couldas, all of which is now being transformed into Jack Guidetti for his team. And a little bit of technical information, having a look at what he's writing down here to try and give them that edge in this next set. They are so close. No question of that. What a really good first set. What a high level of volleyball we witnessed as well. Which you'd expect from some of the world's top players, but what we are seeing as well is the cohesiveness and unity of both teams. And it's all very well having a star player or two or five, but you've got to come together as a team. A great team is the sum of its parts. Great individuals make a great team. Both of those teams in the picture have great individuals. And they are coming together as a team. Don't expect things to happen overnight when the players in. There is that little bit of time needed to bed in, to come to terms with the environment that you're in, the players you're with, the tactics, everything else that goes with it. Away we go with the second set. Conegliano have taken the first, and they're off to an absolute flyer with an ace serve from De Krauf. And it's the one time you get a break point in a set, and it kind of means nothing, because it's just like getting a side out. It's almost as if saying, from a Keith Bank point of view, oh, we said that, you've just sided out. No, that's a big point. That is, I guess, what you call a proper break point. Because now Conegliano, with two ace serves from De Krauf, are up by one, and even if Aki Bank side out, they're still controlling. Bit of pressure here on Gizem. You're going to have to think that De Krauf's going to go after her again. She did. And that's poor from De Krauf. She knows that. Okay, great. She's got 2 points, but there was an opportunity at the very least. She knows that she needed to have made Gizem play that ball. Gizem let off the hook. Foley straight into the action. Wawash is mixing it up really nicely for Conegliano in terms of who she's going to. That always makes it difficult for the blockers. Rasic was unsure where to go with that one. Trying to stop Foley. Wawash with the serve. Milena Rasic into the corner. That backslide behind was pretty much a C-quick, not sliding all the way to the antenna, but sliding just behind the setter. Suddenly it's all square. Way too steep. Kurt Borsch is off on the run, and Ngonu was watching that run and not covering. Good block by Mackie back there in front. Except to Foley. How many times do we see that in volleyball where the setter is pinned by the pass and only goes to the middle, and the middle still gets what amounts to a free swing? Too many times, really, if you're on the opposite side of the net, what happens to you? Touch. Hartley Hill. Both Foley. Looking at each other there, it's to say who touched it was Foley. But, you know, I'd question that because that's Foley's hair. And if your hair touches the net, it doesn't count. That could be a real challenge for Foley, wouldn't it? That was then, this is now. Looking to get the point, and she's done exactly that. Bouncing it off the block and away. A good time to come up with that. A bit of help from the net. Big save. Oh, well kept in play. Conegliano come again, third time lucky. No, it's not! That's a massive block from Gavi! Right back into the face! Serra coming up with the points to Krauf. Got a look at that, that she just didn't want. She gets dug. Then Ognjenović keeps it in play, and then Gavi sends it right back into her face. What a block, what a point! What a match. Covering. Gavi knows how to use those situations. Did she find the hands? She thinks she did. The referee says no, so we'll have a little look at this. Who's going to have the lead at the technical timeout? What we do know is, though, it's a very close second set, just one in it. And again, wonderful volleyball on display. Gavi was only looking for hands here. ever looking for the court. Did Leone's players get their hands out of the way? They leave them dangling, they left them dangling. Brilliant. Bolos has clipped it. That was what was Gabby, that is what Gabby was looking for. And so Bakif back have the lead at the first technical timeout. Here to put Vakif Bank further in front. Unable to take it. Back, couple of missed serves now by the side. Just see the runners. Volleyball would be your ability to come and hit there quick as well. And your middle blockers who could hit pipes and tens. Really well, what a game you have on the outside. You can just run over by the other way. Your rotation will be completely different. You wouldn't need to stack people here, there, and everywhere. Just leave them where they are. So with the middles, because the area is very much reduced, very much focused on two specific things, blocking and spiking the court. From Ognjenovic, not taken away from her at all. It's a wonderful block. She's back with a big lead.
Vai passe 7, va bene, aggressivo in attacco, si tocca a muro, si sporca ogni volta, le transizioni.
He's available through the outside, the German international. Oh, what a set from Volosh. That's ridiculously good. return the point. A one-handed set behind the head for a 10. Tight to the net for Borges. Foley. Lucas M was covered for then by Gabby. And Gabby delivers a massive swing on the pipe. But he banked three ahead. Capitalise on it. Forced out from the serving line. Both teams now have their setter at position one. Village is at position one. Borges is at position six. So both teams have their setters in the back row. Three front court attackers available to them, plus back court options as well. So lots of pressure being put on each other's block. That's huge. Absolutely huge. When you get tight situations like this, even at this level, you still need your go-to players. Gono is the go-to player for Canigliano. Carica delivers again. Still got levels to go to. Just wonder how good she's going to be when she gets her core stability sorted out. She's able to hold herself better in the air. Gets that a little bit stronger as well. Really frightening, really. Touch by Rasic. Swing from Hark. His best Elvis impression, not good enough to keep the ball in play. Change coming then for Canigliano as Chiaka Ogbogu comes in, the USA international through the middle. Side out, back Keith Bank lead by three. The second technical time. That's really well played. The speed of that set giving Gabby a free swing. See ya. Oh, but a better block. Huge block for Serra and Hark. Keith Bank, you're on course to take this set. worry for Santorilli. Looking on as Vlasic gets ready to serve. Let's see who makes the pass. Dejanero's been starved of the ball. Inside out by Vakif Bank. They are doing their utmost to put it anywhere but onto the libero. And now Vakif Bank very happy with this 4-point lead. De Janeiro. Just look at the confidence is oozing through Vakif Bank at the moment. They are exuding it by the bucket load. And what was really good about that was the slightly later block from Serra. And then Lugano was trying to bury it. To do something with the ball. A touch from Ibra. Oh, not such a good one from Paolo Egonu, but Gabby snatching at the ball. It worked well in the end for Conegliano. They take the point. Not a scrappy one, but it's a break point because they were serving. The time match now being called by Guidetti. Can I shout? Oh, we haven't finished. I'll shout again anyway. To like De Janeiro being starved of the ball for a moment, and that's an error from Hark. She's been so good in this match. When those errors come, they are very noticeable. Test of her character now. There's Ognjenović go back to her straight away. No, set up, closed down. It's a real toughie for Hack and didn't play it high. Great blocking by De Graaf to get her hands on that, but at the same time not touch the net, which played it down onto the floor. waiting patiently. So I can better make a change. Everyone's gone off and this meal on blue has come. Change of view here for Hill. The pass by his meal blue. Won too many times though by Ognjenović with that second ball over. Good up from the substitute is Mel Glue. Javi gets a wonderful block out. It's just getting a little tense for Akif Bank in this second set. Their big lead cuts to just 2 points. Walsh almost level things up. From Hack. Good touch from Hack, but not there to have a real swing. Maybe now they can. More space for Ebra. Ogonu's onto it. Chances now for Conegliano. Oh, a block from Serra! Fantastic start. That swung towards Conegliano. They had a chance for a big inside 10, but it was right to where Serra was waiting. One side step, hands across, Ogonu blocked. Lakeith Bank back on track to take this set. Defending too far into court. Coming into the action. Fasino coming in for De Krauf. Fasino normally a libero, but she's actually playing as a swing hitter. That's never gonna happen. She's able to come on and serve and play defense. Swing by Serra. In early, up early, the ball went down even earlier. Absolutely no chance for Sorokay, for anybody. Sorokay had actually gone with the middle and then Ogbogu was out to lunch. Brilliant swing from Serra. Good touch, Gabby. Gets the pipe. But gets blocked. Really good play by Ogbogu. That was 23-20. Still the pressure's on. Conegliano here, they have to get a couple of break points just to get level. They might get one here. Three front court available. Plus Hill, good up by Hack. But she's out of the action. LeBras not though. Dejanero and Hill flat footed as Ebra Karakurt wraps it off the block and away. Keith Bank are now two away from levelling up the match. Moving to a really strong rotation as well to Keith Bank. Ivanovic serving. Hack in the front row, Karakurt in the front row, Rasic in the front row. It's not landed in from Ogbogu. It's set point now for Vakif Bank. Touch, what are they looking for now? Maybe. There was no touch, it's going to be Bucky Bank's point and set point for them. That's a That's another error, two in a row from Ogbogu. She's upset with herself. Becky Bang are absolutely beside themselves because they have leveled things up. It's one set all here in this semi-final in Shaoxing. A complete missing for Ogbogu. It's game on. Kanagiana thought that they were going to win this one 3-0. Well, they're thinking again now about Keith Bank, who came into this as the underdog, knowing that they had to play well, have played well, to take that second set. And it, in fact, was Kanagiana's errors that cost them in that second set. Keith Bank made a few themselves, but played pretty well. This is where the ball has been spiked by Keith Bank. Digs made, but look at the spread. They're getting those sidelines. And then in the second set, they actually got a little bit more through the block and able to go a little bit steeper. Passing, which I think was the best to go away. Probably the hit of the match so far was definitely from Karaka in the first set, which you might know why. It's going to be time to see how Conegliano respond to that second set defeat. Whether or not they move up to another level, take it out on Keith Bank, or whether or not Keith Bank have now reached a level that is equal to Conegliano. Tussle right to the end. Away we go with the third set. Gabby with the serve for Keith Bank. It's 1-1 here in Shaoxing in this first semi-final. Sided out by Sia. Ball in from Kisem, a little bit flat, a little bit Japanese style. So Bogdanovic has to go quickly. Lilano, but she comes up with a block. Well, I say she did, it wasn't, was it? Serra again. What a marvellous game the youngster's having. Celia, I wonder what she sees, whether she can see Serra in a peripheral vision or not, whether she just sees the ball and that's it. Peripheral vision is a really important part of volleyball. A setting when you are spiking, you're looking at the ball, but in your peripheral vision, you need to see where the blockers are, where the gaps are that you're looking to go through. You're not going to see the court in that moment, but your awareness of where the court is from that is important. Thank you. covering by Foley. And Donny wraps it off the block. Federer thinks he's not been playing that long. Oh my God, he won in 1998. Started with the Italian Junior Team Club, Italian Carrera 2013. Went to Igor Gugatola, Nevada in 2017, right until last season. May well be playing against them. Results go on this one. Move to Conegliano this season. Top dig by De Janeiro. Claimed the MVP of the World Championships under 18 in 2015, plus best outside hitter. Best score at the European Champs in 2017. The Montreux Volley Masters MVP. World Championships 2018, best scorer, best opposite. Play. Nice swing from Foley. Getting off to a good start in this third set. Hips under to get the angle to keep the ball in play. No arm movement at all, so the arms were closer to the body, but movement of the hips under the ball, changing the angle of the body to be able to make the dig. Unfortunately, though, Mack just lost sight of the angle she needed. Foley now with the serve. Serbia with Sumadija, then went to Penchevo. From there in 2010, she went to Cannes in France for four seasons before coming to Bangkok in 2014. With a point for her team. 16 individual awards so far in her time. She was Champions League best middle blocker in 2017-18. Club World Championships best middle blocker last year. That's a good going. That's a good dig by De Janeiro. That from Gabby available as well. And is used and uses the ball to great effect. Technical timeout just for the last set with one between them, and that's great for Vakifbank because it was looking a little worrying at the start of this third set as Conegliano went up very quickly and got in front. It will be Conegliano who have the lead as we head to that first technical of this third set. That is a very evenly contested semi final. Thank you. Gill will serve. Gabby again with that quick swing going inside past the wing blocker towards the middle against De Cruyff and Foley. She's had really good success because they are both late getting to the position they need to be in. And they're leaving a gap between themselves and the net. It's going down their side. Touched by Hack. That's a better block. She's got to love Emma Carragher's mentality. She's just been roofed. And then she goes, oh, is that right? A little look back to De Cruyff. With the serve. She's looking for touches. Surprised there wasn't one. The 29-year-old convinced there was. Challenge. Sylvia's playing innocent. This one. Holly Hill with a connection to Vakeef Bank, in that she played for them in 2015-2016 season. That one hasn't touched anybody. Acknowledging that, he knows it hasn't, that's fine, carry on. It's a bit of a blocky picture on the big screen when it gets blown up to that size. And the ball goes past the fingers that closely and the shadows appear. It looks, can look as if there's a touch, but there wasn't. Good luck from Volosh. Very delicate touch that from Igonu. Enjoying that one as well. But that's what you need to grab that variety. You can't just be a big hitting machine. You want to come in tight to the net, tempt the player to try and play it. Use the block, make it your best friend. Bolash with the serve. Able to get that point with a tip from the 3 metre line on her side. The ball's travelled so far. De Janeiro, understandably, really disappointed. Her hand was up early, showing what was coming. For some reason, De Janeiro not telling herself to go after the ball in time. Everyone thinks that one is in, everyone else thinks it's out, so we'll challenge. She can convince the coach to challenge the lead. She has done. And, Santarelli. So, all right, we'll go with the challenge. Cool, well, they've lost the challenge. tough rotation for that Keith Bank to have to deal with. The two wing players at that point, even though it's rotation one and Cynthia's on the wrong side, Agona's on the wrong side. So they're hitting out of position. They're still able to put pressure on and come up with the point eventually. Cynthia now with the serve. Big swing again. Stuff in front of the setter, such as their firepower on the 10. The whip they have going behind with Agona, they don't need to run their slides so much. So not getting in a neutral position to play that. She was still moving a little bit to the right and then forward to the right. So it was off balance. But you don't fight for position in defense, you fight for the ball. So if you are out of position, stay there, play from where you are. You're off at Cynthia now, two in a row. You don't still have to think about that deal. Behind you, back Keith Bank have leveled up. Renetti is stoking the fire here for that Keith Bank. Message with the serve. Really well played. Milinovic had jumped, but then it was just out of her reach. Going to the second technical timeout, just 1 point separating these teams. If Keith Bank can side this out, an easy one to side out. So it's proved Hack has slowed down into transition for Conegliano. Hill works the block. We will go to the second technical timeout. Conegliano leading by two. Kept in play by Cilia, but it's a good swing from Gabby yet again to get Keith Bank the side out. Slightly better defending from Cilia because that's now come off the block and changed direction. Very nearly made an excellent dig. Oh, well played, De Gennaro. Well played, Hill. Brilliant out assistant play. Santorelli applauding that. Santorelli signed a 2-year deal to be coach of the Croatian women's national team. It's a job with them till 2021, all being well. Lindenhack. Milic is getting upset, either with herself or with the players around her, but that doesn't bode well. Luciana now three in front. This is where Becky Bank have to settle down, get back in, find their rhythm. Not happening at the moment, Gabby gets blocked. Everyone in covering around the 3 meter line, no one deep. De Cruyff comes up with the kill block stats. We'll go to the timeouts. As called by Vakif Bank, they're four behind in this set.
Come di stai down, dentro di stai down qua.
Hai! Hai, hai, hai!
Go! Double change.
Go, 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 double.
Apologises for the error, doesn't stop Vakif Bank getting the point. Casino coming in as she has done. Throughout this match so far, coming in to serve and play some defense. Oh yes, that'll do nicely. In to go off for De Janeiro to come on. Looks a little complicated, it's just reversing the substitution, and because De Cruyff's the middle, she does a pass, so the libero comes in for that. That's a net touch against Vakif Bank and against Ismail Blue. He actually has him on the shirt, first name. Surname, Ekonu. Blasting that one. Lomosh. Luciano are disciplined now in their blocking. Karakurt not having the success she had earlier in this match. Timeout called by Vakif Bank.
Everybody, just play. Everybody,
serves once again. Ismailoglu deals with it. That's no double touch given against Paolo Gonna. Look, she dug it onto her shoulder, but a simultaneous contact, so play continues. And well, it goes the way of Aggie Bank. Back in, Katsu off. Milovic in, Ismailoglu off. Go to serve. Hackinson's front row with Rasic and Karakurt. This is where they really do have to get back into the set now across the next couple of rotations, whilst they've got the advantage in the front row in terms of attackers. Plus the extra. Karmak in. Volwash, back row setter. Ball tight and high on the net. So there's nothing she can do but try and stop it from going over, and the only set available is the middle. That's it, nothing else. And yet, for some reason, Akif Bank unable to stop it. First time on court for Jennifer Gerties, the German international. Oh dear, that's not a good touch from De Janeiro. She knows it. She just put that on a plate for Rasic. Trouble here for Santorelli for that outburst to the second referee. So Rogerio Escapowski is a pretty calm guy, just letting the captain know to calm it down. Gerties is going to stay in, passing duty. Uster, who's just come on, and some serving duty. As well, but an excellent side out from Kim Hill. Out of system play, blockers against her, but able to go over the top and roll it to the line. Ebra back in. Set point for Finnish Liano. Sorokai comes in. Flexible player, Soroka can play opposite, can play through the outside. It's a great jump serve. Free ball here for Konosliano. Who's going to take it? Soroka has to step in. There's no libero. Gerties and Soroka getting in a bit of a mix up, and that then is compounded by the goal. Struck that one off though. That far ahead. Message. Does he ever put under pressure? He'll get stopped. Two set points saved. Momentum with Vakif Bank. There's Liano just trying to shrug it off again. the ball in from Gerties. And it's a really good continuation block. Ighonu goes for the second time, and she's missed it. That is three set points saved by Vakif back now. This is purely a mental thing for Konechny-Arnold. They looked up at the scoreboard, 24-19, and thought, yeah, we've got this. To switch back on pretty quickly here. Good ball from Hill. Oh, yes, what a block! Sarah committing in the middle of that Vakif bank, and now just one away. This would be incredible. Incredible if they could turn it around. It would be potentially a game changer. To Cruyff with an emphatic block from Serra and nowhere to go. So Torelli with a very positive body language, smiling. He's not phased just yet. I mean, it's 24, it's 23-24, but they still have this chance, they still have this opportunity, another chance to win the set from Sinai. And then he'd still get another chance to get set point, but then he would have to get a point from service. Now or never then, potentially, for Konechny-Arnold. Good ball from Gerties, is it? Not quite. And it's into transition here, Ognjenović. But they couldn't do something with it. Maybe now, though, it's... Oh, that's a bit tight. It's too tight. This is a real scramble. Good dig from Gerties. Di Gennaro pushing everybody out of the way. And eventually, they get the point as Ighonu hammers it to position one. And Konechny-Arnold take the set, 25-23. That was not easy in the end. Di Gennaro tripping Gerties up. But really, what a top swing that was from Paolo Ighonu. Tight to the net, but over the top of the block. She comes up with the goods. Konechny-Arnold take the set. They lead 2-1 here in Shaoxing. Just over an hour and a half. And it's been real quality, really exciting as well. Konechny-Arnold will be feeling good about themselves because they got over the line in that last set. And that really is all that matters is you get over the line. Okay, brilliant from Becky Beck, brilliant from Sarah, who's probably on course for a Best Middle Blocker award here at this World Club Championships. Regardless of the outcome of this one, and potentially even the outcome of the next one. In fact, Sarah Gunes is top of the blockers. 15 staff blocks going into this game. Robin de Kralf in second place with 11. Best scorers so far, well, Isabella Hack from Keith Bank is the best scorer. As we get this fourth set underway, Hack having a hack at it. Gabby having a go with that trademark turn of hers. She brings her arm around to swing on the ball. Kimberly Hill is the best attacker. Paolo Egonu, the second best attacker. Surprisingly, Tiana Boskovic is the best server in this tournament. Misha Hancock is the second best setter. Opposite we'll be seeing both of those a little later for the second semi-final. Joanna Walsh, well, she's the best setter of the tournament so far, and Ognjenović is the second best. We'll see both of them in action here. Speeds that ball up into the middle for Serra to have the swing. It is a must-win set here for Vakif Bank. And for those who are supporting the Turkish side, you definitely want them to win. For those who are supporting Kunizliani, you want them to win in this set and then the match. And I guess for the rest of us, us neutrals, we'd like to see five sets. Enjoying more than anything else is the great volleyball that we're seeing. The problem solving that's going on by these two teams as this game unfolds individually and as a unit. Well played. Walsh can go under the net, that's absolutely fine, as long as he doesn't interfere with anybody on the other side of the net. And it's quite crazy, really, isn't it? Because Walsh is way under the net, but her feet were on her own side, so that's fine. Nice play. Gonu having Hack and Gabby go after it but not get it. Cynthia now with the serve. Oh, brilliant angle from Serra. Serra really has burst onto the scene in world volleyball. Has been at Vakif Bank since 2017 and that's it. He's played internationally under 18s in 2015, World Championships, best middle blocker, and then the best middle blocker for under 20s in 2017. So, it's surprising that she's making it to the seniors. Having an impact for Vakif Bank. Foley with the serve. So, training by one at the moment. Ball in by Kishen. Sarah again. One meter 97. Sarah Gunes. Spikes at 319, blocks at 310. Lead the stats. Jumpers. This is all good for Vakif Bank. decent start to the set. They're in front by two. They know that even if they want to get something here, they can still side out next and still stay in front of it. Exactly done that, haven't they? Ngannou has ripped into that to beat Gabby, and that's not easy. Gabby, the second best passer at this World Club Championships at the moment, behind Suela Pinto, who's been playing for Dentil of Brazil. Suela Pinto, the libero, who's also played national team alongside Gabby. Celia unhappy she didn't get it. Didn't matter though, because there was a net touch. Stayed two in front. Well played by Ngannou. Good up from Celia. Oh, lovely from Ebra. She knew where that was going. Just the one so far. His serve, big front row for Vakif back, but they can't stop Ngannou on the pipe, the Bic, as it's also known, which is backcourt quick. That's incredible. It was all tucked up so close to Ebra that she was backing off. She couldn't do anything. Try to flick it up. Touch De Janeiro, but it won't stay in play. Celia entitled to chase after it, as it was dug and went outside the antenna. And that's again a bit saying to Hack, a little bit more of the smiles, please. Come on. Ivanovic, very much the mother figure for the Vakif Bank team. Ivanovic at 35, you've got Ebra 19, Serra 20, those two 19 and 20, and Isabella Hack not much older. Despite the age, it's a team that are playing some superb volleyball. Are really giving Canigiano a run for their money here. That's just brilliant to watch. Gabby over the top of Rasic. It's like a piston's working. Rasic up. As he comes down, Gabby comes up. It's an easy put away as a result of that free swing. Everyone brought in, suckered in by Rasic in the middle. And they know great serve. Ognjenović has pulled the strings really well for Vakifbek. Bolwash has also done the same. She's had good distribution that time, finding Ngonu with relative ease. Just like Vakifbek, Lano have moved into a strong series of rotations. That's one of the best efforts of De Janeiro. There's no chance of digging that out once again. A wonderful hit. Top serve from Hack. Canigliano scrambled the side out. Guidetti not really happy with that, because he had got Canigliano out of system. Hack had reduced the options that Canigliano had. They weren't able to stop Signe. Well played, Gabby. Oh, brilliant play! Set. Tell you what, so I hope Ognjenović is behind that 3 metre line, because she is a back row player. Only now just moving into the front row. Hack destroys the ball down the line. Vakifbek up by three. Guidetti's loving it. Moment of stillness for Ognjenović as she sets the ball, which is just freezing Canigliano's block. They don't know where it's going until too late. In time, Vakifbek not closing the block properly. Ball gets the swing set up, left a gap between herself and the net, which is why it goes down her side. Screaming for touch. You only get 8 seconds after the whistle goes to make your challenge. Yes, he may not have been so convinced, but it is up to the players to help the coach out, really. If they see that touch, they need to let him know. They need to tell them to call him or her to call for the challenge. Suggest that this is close. Just how close? When I say it's close, as in the ball is close to the hands. And just like in life in general, and also in volleyball, you are walking the proverbial tightrope in terms of how this goes. Where's the touch? What? Hold on, I'm not. Well, I'll tell you what, that's a horrible one from our point of view. Looking at that on the screen, that tells us nothing at all, because of the finger being taped up. Now we might see it better. Oh yes, that's much better. That's all we wanted to see the first time, really. That was the finger wobble, that was the touch. And, really good work by the directors who show us the broadcast camera version. After all that, Sarah fluffs her lines from the serving line. But Vakifbek stay in front. how long remains to be seen. Ghana is going to try and close the gap with her jump serve. Oh dear, Gabby unsure where Hack was, she's got in away. Free ball for Conegliano, that was close to the line from Ngannou. Play continues. Hill, good dig from Kissem. Good dig from Silla. Oh, and then Hill has put too much on it. It was there to be hit. It was a tricky one because she's having to turn around and get the ball, gets herself in relation to the net. Eventually, Becky Fang take the point, they get the side out. They're going back to three in front and they move back into a strong series of rotations. Ognjenović with the serve. Into the front row with Rasic and Ebra. Ebra for 16-13, not going to happen. Ooh, that was an opportunity. Costly, they can still side out. That would have been a 16-12. That would be huge, huge. 16-13 would be good enough, though, if they can score. Hill's had points from her serving during the course of this match. It's not an easy rotation, this, for Vakif Bank, even with three front-row attackers. But Gabby takes care of business on the pipe. We'll go to the second technical timeout. Vakif Bank leading by three. Isliana leading by 2-1. Once again, Vakif Bank find themselves in a really good position. In front by three. But a Karakurt to the serving line. She's got a jump serve to bring. Oh, going with the jump float serve, so keeping it in and actually almost coming up with the point. But Silla with a very smart play to wrap that one off the hands and out. Touching it last. From Gabby. Ognjenović has an interesting action when she sets that middle with her hands in the way that she keeps the ball. She has one hand in front of her, one hand to the side as she sets those balls to the middle at times. Court goes off. Rasic will serve. View from the end-on cameras, the speed of that ball goes from left to right and back again. Really quick ball out to Gabby, who likes to operate in that time frame. Vakif Bank open up a bigger lead now. What a set on Ognjenović. What a hit for Gabby. So they've called the timeout. Watts in at the moment, number 8. Good Kinek. A little blocker. And Libro Pina, number 12, haven't played in this match for Lakeith Bank. Everyone else has been involved. Foley getting involved with a blistering swing through the middle. Three players not been on court for Luciano. The setter, Giulia Gennari. The backup opposite, Henry Onwu. And the blocker, Bortezat. Here for Canisliano, taken by Ogonu. That's a great swing again, isn't it? They're just time after time, the height and power of these athletes is brilliant to behold. 3:09. That's pretty good going. Up from Volosh, an easy one that for Ogonu. Does well to keep it in play, as does Karakurt. Hack, oh yes, that one just going off the block and the deflection off the hands, catching Volosh by surprise. Touch. Oh, what a pick out by De Janeiro. Wonderful volleyball. And Lakeith Bank take the point. That was an incredible dig by De Janeiro off of one of Gabby's best. And then Hack comes in. Gets the better of Hill. Still in play. Ogonu did really well not to touch the net and also to make sure the contact was on her side. So the side out achieved by Canisliano. Gerties in to serve. Chance here for Canisliano. They haven't taken it, they could be penalised. They are, because Ognjenović does her fourth second ball over. She's scored with three of them so far in this match. An easy leave. Lakeith Bank in such a good place right now. Fassino in, as she has done throughout this match. That's an easy ball, well passed. But what a really, really good block by Canisliano. This is going to get the better of Ibra.
Hey!
It's never too many times, I suppose, if you keep scoring with it, but Ognjenović didn't, however. Another bite of the cherry here for Vakif Bank, and Serra slide behind takes the Turkish side now to within 3 points of levelling up this match and sending us into a five-set decider. Buster. Coming on to serve for Vakif Bank. Ball goes well through the outside. Who is going to come up with the points required here for Konecliano to get back into this set? That's the question. Senna was on to come off again, so the libero can come in. Kisem. Just comes back to the benches to Cicero. Ugonu finds some points. It's a good serve. That means there's no middle coming here. Hack from way off, but she just makes it look so easy. She's hit that from 3 metres away from the net. Threading the needle, gets it between Gürtis and Ugonu for the point. More trouble here for Konecliano. Free ball for Vakif Bank. Three front court attackers. Gabby waiting on the pipe. It's Hack who gets it. It's going to be another free ball. Oh, no one have to worry about it because Hill's trying to win the point in that situation. Poor choice from Hill. Brilliant for Vakif Bank. It's set point now for them. That's what Guidetti thinks. Timeout called by Konecliano. They're in trouble in this set, that's for sure. Serve, making De Kruijf have to play it. Gabby unable to keep it in play. Set point saved by Ugonu. The three slide-out opportunities here for Vakif Bank to send us into a fifth set decider. To serve. Hack for the set. Does it. First time of asking. Isabella Hack with the tip. Vakif Bank with the point. It's two sets all here in Shaoxing. We're into and going to a fifth set decider to see who will be going to the final. Just over 2 hours of volleyball played so far, and we are unable to separate these two teams. So, Jirio Espigassi meets with the two captains to toss the coin again to see who serve and receive the jet. Confirmation of the set scores 25-23, 25-20, 25-23, 25-21. volley only gave Bank 2 points, but they were critical in terms of the context, in terms of what those in terms of where things happened. To take on board some fluid and some sugar to get ready for this race to 15. There's no technical there are no technical timeouts in the fifth set. Two challenges plus two regular timeouts. That's a normal number of substitutions. As soon as one team gets to 8 points, we will change ends. The two teams will change ends, come back and get right on with it. And that's just to make sure that everything's fair in terms of the ends. And kind of more of a hang-up, really, from back when the game was played on point scoring, but also when the volleyball was white. Does that really to make a difference in some places, what the ball looked like from one end of the court to the other when you were playing? But now, though, with this new volleyball, it really makes no difference at all. In fact, it's a new volleyball. It's a new one. It's being in the World Cup in Japan just a few months back. 18 panels, different design. It has been received very well by the community. Fifth set is underway here in Shaoxing between Vekif Bank and Konechliano. First to 15 for a place in the final of the Women's World Club Championship, and the first point goes the way of Vekif Bank as Gabby hammers one on the pipe. And a real statement of intent from the Brazilian outside hitter. Konechliano could not deal with it. Swing from Igonu and we're all square. Konechliano were involved in a 3-2 victory over Minas. Tambay Minas. And the fifth set was 28-26, a record fifth set score for a World Club Championship. You really don't want that to happen again, but they'll take it if it means they can win. Right now, though, it's Vekif Bank who have the lead. Ebra. Good ball from Celia gives Boros the opportunity to have a little look through the net, see where everyone is, decide then where she's going to go. Got the swing. Well kept in play, not quite. Chase that from Volos, risking injury by getting so close to the advertising hoardings. They are not going to move for you. McGonu thinks that there was a touch, so they're going to challenge it. She was put in a difficult situation with that set. There was. who have the serve. Ooh, the out call came late. And Keith back now with a chance here. Hack goes with the tip. Well up by De Janeiro. Hill gets the block out. Can Esliano survive? Get themselves back to within a point. It's going to be a real test of character for both of these teams and the players involved when it comes to these crunch situations. Bill falters from the serving line. Jump serve has been really good throughout this match. It continues to be so. That's a good dig from Ebra. Gabby, a little tight, but she gets the block out because there was confusion by Conegliano as to who was then going to play the ball as it came off the block. Guidetti must be thinking to himself, well played, Bosch took her hands out of the way. Maybe that should have been the thing that De Graaf should have done as well. Ooh, Celia went too early. Gabby. And she gets the block out. What a player to have on your team. A player who's been there and done it and is part of a team as well in Brazil, who just never give up and never give in and fight to the end, because they know as a team, as a national team, the teams they're up against are always bigger, stronger, hit harder. So their defence, their tenacity, their skill has to be up there. Their improvisation has to be there. And at 7-3, this is in brilliant position.
Arms together, arms in front. All you guys, go! 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 Go!
Be dismissive anymore of what Maggie Bank have been doing to them. This is brilliant from Gabby. De Graaf looking through the net as if she's wanting to get something going with Gabby or with Gizem, but neither of them looking at her. Nothing to do about it. Hack to serve again. License to go after this one, really, even though it's off the back of the timeout. She's already got one in, so she's on an even keel with her serving in this set. Here's your jump server. When you're jump serving, the risk reward is such that you really need to go for your serves. Put the other team out of the system, try and get yourself a free ball back, maybe get the ace. Casino in to serve. Three behind, Conegliano, what have they got in the locker to get back level, to get in front, to win the game even? Have they got anything left in the locker? Can the Keith Bank keep the door shut? Doing it at the moment, we're going to change hands. Now Keith Bank up 8-4. Hack and Gabby, the go-to players. Then you add in Sarah, you add in Karaka, and then sprinkle on a bit of Rasic with Ognjenović pulling the strings. That Keith Bank are looking the better side, no question. And they are proving it with the way they're playing. 8-4 up. Brilliant, brilliant volleyball. Right now, Conegliano have no answer. With the serve. Ooh. Adrenaline flowing, not too much into that one. Coach with the assault on the player, misses a serve, and they're part of the passing unit. Just say, okay, make up for it with a good pass. That's all Gabby can do, and then be available perhaps on the pipe. Because with the good pass, Hack with the brilliant angle cross court to get past Bosch. That Keith Bank are the team that are moving through the gears. Canigliano have got a bit of sand in theirs at the moment. Serhat Gustev comes in. Gabby telling Gustev she's going to go and play defence. Probably going to play at six so she can hit the pipe. Gustev probably will play at five. And she does go to five. Overpass! And put away by Evra. They're on the verge here of a place in the final. They won't be getting carried away just yet. Silja gets taken off though. Soroka 8 comes in. Be the serving target here for Gustev. Soroka 8 has been on, but she's not really up to game speed. Where does Gustev go? Gennaro gets it. That's off the block. Bono has the point for her team. That's a good passage of play by Vakif Bank to get a point from serve, to get a break point. That's incredible. They've got no reps off of Rasic's thumb. Now Sorokaik with the serve. Confidence to go with the jump serve, as you would expect. Well passed by Gabby. Rasic was trying to guide that towards the sideline, but didn't really hit through the ball properly, get the wrap on it she would have liked. So a great point for Konechlianu. Things get that little bit more interesting now. It's only three behind. Alarm bell's definitely not ringing the mic for Vakif Bank. Sorokaik with the serve. Another top ball in from Gabby. Bogdanovic is dug, a pancake. Good pick up from Gabby. Hack with work to do. Oh, and she does it brilliantly. Just incredible stuff from Isabella Hack. Bogdanovic again making it difficult for Konechlianu. And even though it was difficult for Vakif Bank, what a swing that is. Bogdanovic now with the serve. That's a chase for Gabby, but it's too far away. One thing that Vakif Bank are doing, and they have done really for the last few sets, is make the court seem really small, because they're touching just about everything that Konechlianu throw at them. Difficult to remember a clean winner. Gertie's in. Well, that was Bogdanovic trying to be a little bit too clever. The license to do it, is such a good setter. Going to Rasic. Rasic knows. Able to do something with the ball. Krauf is fired up. It's a great block from De Krauf. Just see from the body language, from the interaction of these players, there's a real belief about what they're doing, and a belief in the fact that they can get it done. Belief in themselves. Gertie's with the serve again here for Konechlianu. We're trying to get back into this. Two behind. Good ball from Gizem. Options here. One of them is Karakurt, who wraps it off of Hill's block and out of play. And Vakif Bank now 3 points away from what, at the start of this match, seemed like an unlikely victory. That's it in. That's an ace serve on the line from Karakurt. It's a huge serve. There's a challenge coming. The line judge had given it out. Mr. Espikowski had said it was in and gave it the way of Vakif Bank. Konechlianu dearly hope this is out. It's all about how much of this ball is impacted down on the line. Enough of it has impacted on the line for it to be an ace serve and send the fans into raptures. He knew it was in. That's experience for you, that is. Carricker once again. Ball in of sorts. And Gonu tidies things up. This is such a good position for Vakif Bank if they just keep their focus. Eyes off the scoreboard, eyes on the server. Stay in the now. One action at a time. Get the side out. And that's a good play from Guidetti. He's brought in Isameoglu. This is purely to get those side outs. And they've been given one by Igonu. It's now match point for Vakif Bank. They are on the verge of a huge upset here in Shaoxing at this Women's World Club Championship. First match point is saved. It's a very good swing from Igonu. Hill missed a last serve. Make sure that one goes in. Gabby. Oh, it's a continuation block. Hack for the victory. Good up from Vosch. Igonu, big swing from her, second match point saved. Real tension on court. And now Vakif Bank call the timeout. This is exciting. Guidetti just looking, staying calm. And in so doing, keeping his team calm. Serve again. Still two opportunities for Vakif Bank to win. Gabby, oh, gets dug by Hill. Another tough one for Igonu. Oh, I say! That is phenomenal from Paolo Igonu. Talk about bringing out your best when your back's to the wall. Three match points saved. Conegliano bench, can't believe it, that is incredible from Igonu. Hill once more, last chance here for Vakif Bank. Hack! She's missed it! This is unbelievable! It was there for the taking for Vakif Bank. And Conegliano have saved four match points. Or have they? Quite a challenge coming. Oh my goodness me, what a turnaround. Hearts are in mouths right now, around the world. It's 14 all. It's now the first to get two clear. A slight advantage with Van Kieftbank. They've got to get this side out. That's how things have gone. I think as well, Van Kieftbank have used both their challenges. They've got none left now. Don't quote me on that. Hill serves again. It's kept in play. Sorokaites. It's only a continuation. Gabby. Oh! Unbelievable! That's five in a row! And Conegliano have gone from facing four match points, and now they've got a match point. Surely not. Surely Conegliano are not going to do this 16-14, are they? They are going to break Van Kieftbank hearts, are they? Van Kieftbank have to side it out. Have to. Do. Zera puts it down. 15 all. Strap in, everybody. This is a roller coaster. And we are all in the front seat watching this one. Goodness me, what a game. Hack with the serve. Conegliano siding out for match point. Oh, what a good serve that is. Iguanu, down ball, out ball. Match point again for Van Kieftbank, but now they have to win it from the serving line. Oh, you can barely watch. Imagine what it must be like for the players on court. For those of you that have been in this situation, you know exactly what it's like. Hack once again. Now would be a good time for an ace. It's a well-passed ball by De Janeiro. And it's a brilliant swing from Iguanu to level up once more. The drama, the excitement. That's why we all love volleyball. Why do you love it and hate it at the same times? At the same time, sometimes you put through the ringer like this. Hack. That's not coming back. Again, Van Kieftbank have a match point. Seven in it now. My reckoning. Seven. It's ridiculous. How many more chances they're going to get? But for both teams, they have to do it from serve. Gabby. Belter from Iguanu. That's a big clean winner. They've been few and far between. But that's a good time to really get in there and hammer that ball down without anyone getting a touch on it. There'll be no opportunity for Ebrad to go off. She'll have to stay in and pass. Ismailagi has already been in this set. Well played by Semi. That's confidence from the youngster. And also brilliant from Ognjenovic to go to her in that situation. Gwileni's got to check here. Obviously, he needs to be aware of what substitutions he's had and who's been on and done what in terms of what he's done. He can't take Zera off because Gusta's already come in and come out again. Good serve. Iguanu with work to do. Oh, it's going to go the way of Conegliano. There was a moment there where Hack had made the dig and maybe it was going to stay in play, but it just seems that Iguanu's gone within herself, hasn't she, to another place where she's just becoming a point machine. For Conegliano, Sorokay to the serving line. It's not happening for Conegliano at the moment from the serving line. Maybe it will get round to Hill and she can unlock the the door once more, unlock that key. Use that key to unlock the door, I should say. Another match point for Mijenovic. No nails left for the fans and for the bench. Oh, I don't believe it. Mijenovic was trying to make that difficult, to put it in the traffic, to drop it short over at position two. But now she's got to forget about that. She's got to organise her offence from rotation one. Three front court attackers available, plus the pipe. Foley with the serve. Good up by Foley. Hill. Good up from Gissem. That's a magnificent dig. This is a bit tight. Hack has to use it. Bit of a scramble here. Iguodu! Brilliant, brilliant swing from Iguodu. Canigliano turning around again. They have match points. What an epic match. What an epic fifth set. The players on court keeping their focus. Gissem in trouble. Carricker. Oh, yes! What maturity from Carricker. That was incredible. We're all square again. Brilliant. Well, that's a good serve. It's going to be free ball here. No, it won't be free ball. It doesn't come over. And it's Ebra, who perhaps is taking this set by the scruff of the neck now. Guidetti celebrating with her, because that's 2 points in a row from Ebra. And with the ball in hand now, she could decide the fate of this match. Has she got another big serve in the locker? Bet she's going to go for it. Good pass from Hill. And a really good swing from Hill. Ebra almost kept that in play. This has been and is a fantastic game of volleyball. That is gone to the wire and passed it. We've gone into extra time. Now we're into penalties. Oh, good dig! Just brilliant! It is just magnificent. Getting lost for words here in how to describe the level that these players are playing at. It's match point now for Konechlianu. There are going to be some tears, some serious tears at the end of this one. Regardless of who wins. Top ball in from Gabby. Good up from Gissem. Gabby again. Oh, it's a block from Canigliano! And they have won it! They have beaten Vakif Bank! And the celebrations can begin. An incredible game of volleyball comes to an end. Vakif Bank had, well, what must have been 10 chances to win the game. Four in a row from side out. Well, they're going to check for a near touch, just in case. One last gasp attempt here from Vakif Bank. Satoru's like, what? We've won! We've won! We know we've won. We do know we've won, but they've got to stand up just for protocol. There was no net touch, was there? What a brilliant game of volleyball. There is no net touch. Gabby is blocked by Vorosh. And Konechlianu have booked their place in the final of the Women's World Club Championship here in Shaoxing. A volleyball game of the highest order. Worthy of an international match, let alone a club match. Heartbreak for Vakif Bank. They're going to have to pick themselves up and bounce back ready for the bronze medal game. They can be really, really pleased with how they played overall. At the moment, though, they'll be desperately disappointed because they had the chances and didn't take them. And that will be the thing that always breaks. It always does. To turn around and go, oh, well, we played well, you did. They played amazing, but they had a chance, and that's the difference. Just didn't quite happen. It almost happened, didn't it? Ebra almost made it happen, but then it was Paolo Igonu who made it happen. And Vosh, who came up with the block for Conegliano to come up with the win. Goodness me, what a game. The emotions can flow now, as you might expect, because everybody's given it everything. And it is tears for Carrickert, which is a real shame. There's nothing to be upset about. Well, that is the cruelty and the beauty of volleyball. There has to be a winner. And on this occasion and on this moment, it is Conegliano who have that victory. 15-14 in the attacks. No blocks for Istanbul. Five errors each. If you want to have your thoughts on the game, hashtag FIVB Women's CWC. Get involved on social media and tell us all about it. It was incredible, wasn't it? Absolutely incredible. 117-114. Vakif Bank actually outscored Conegliano in points, but it's not about the points, it's about the sets that were won. And Conegliano 1-3 and got the job done. Gona's waiting patiently, and we can have a word with her.
Paula, congratulations, what a game. Five sets, 23-21 in the last one. I've still goosebumps of this game. What do you think about this five-set game?
I really think we are an amazing team. We never stopped pushing. We kept fighting, and I'm really proud of this team, seriously.
You were back in the fifth set, 10-14. You had then already four match balls against you. What do you think during this game? Oh, man.
I didn't understand.
No, you had four match points, 10-14 against you. What do you think during this time of the game?
You don't think nothing. You just play.
And now you are in the final. Which team you would like more? Your colleagues from the Italian league or Eşasibası from Turkish league tomorrow?
Seriously, I don't care. I just want to win. So they can play their game, and then tomorrow who win, we play against us. I'm okay.
Thank you so much.
Scenes of joy for Conegliano. What a breathtaking game that was. They're through to the final. Keith Bank will be playing for bronze. Up next, we've got Navarra against Istanbul. It's Italy versus Turkey all over again. Who's going to be going to the final? Well, we hope you can stay with us. But until then, from all of us here, it's time to say goodbye.